In Istanbul, Turkey, it's one of the toughest tickets to get in this country's sporting history. The gold medal game to close the 2010 FIBA World Championship. Host nation Turkey getting set to face the reigning Olympic champs from Team USA. Let's take a look at the end of the brackets. Lithuania winning the bronze a short time ago. The U.S. beat Lithuania last night behind Kevin Durant's record 38 points to get to the gold medal game. And if you missed it last night, after the U.S. win, Turkey and Serbia played an absolute classic. Down one, Turkey's Kerem Tunçeri scored with a half second to go on that layup to regain the lead, but they needed Semi Ertens' late deflection to finish the win over Serbia, which touched off celebrations from Istanbul to Ankara and all points across this country. And we welcome you inside a raucous Olympic Dome in Istanbul with Fran Fraschilla. I'm Mark Kestisher. Fran, we'll get to the U.S. in a moment. But we got a building international basketball story with this Turkish team.
Well, you and I have had a great basketball experience watching Turkey go undefeated and having a chance to play for the World Championship on their home court. Everybody we've met in the last 24 hours is talking about this game.
For the United States, one win away from reclaiming World Championship gold for the first time since 1994, but a win today would also mean something else for this team.
Well, only the world champion gets the automatic bid to the 2012 Olympics, and credit Coach K. He's done a marvelous job with a very young team. None of them were in the Olympics in 2008. They played great basketball, particularly defensively, but they're going to have to play with poise in this face of this great crowd today.
And a check of the starting lineups. Names familiar on the Turkey side to NBA fans. Hito Turkoglu, Ersan Ilyasova. But Fran, the guards, Onan and Tunçeri, really kept Turkey alive in that game against Serbia.
Solid defenders, excellent outside shooters. They're veterans. They don't turn the ball over. That will be a key for Turkey today.
On the U.S. side, in the first game against Lithuania in the friendlies in Madrid, was the last time we saw a lineup different than this. Starting with the Spain game, they have stayed with it, and it has worked for Coach Krzyzewski.
Coach K has done a tremendous job of building role players for this team. Kevin Durant has been the go-to scorer, but everybody chips in different ways. This team is cohesive, and they're going to have to be tonight.
Well, it is just about a sea of red here in Istanbul. And this may be the quietest it will be all evening in Istanbul. For those just jumping on the tournament, Team USA has not won gold in the World Championship since 1994. Turkey has never medaled. They're 18th in the FIBA rankings, but they're trying to seize an opportunity on their home floor last night, down 8 points, the unbelievable finish, and trying to carry that momentum. A look at Coach Mike Krzyzewski, who's only lost one time since taking over the national team. What a job he has done with a 12-man roster, only three players who have international experience, one with Olympic experience. Otherwise, he has taken 12 very young players, nine of them very young, and have them within a win of a world championship.
And that's going to be a key today in this atmosphere, because this young team, other than the guys you mentioned, has very little playoff pressure experience.
Bojan Tanjevic, the coach of Turkey. He's from Montenegro. He's been the head coach right here in Istanbul at Fenerbahce, one of the top clubs in Turkey. In fact, he's leaving Turkey after this, but he's been the national coach, has done a fabulous job.
Now, he's an old school guy. He coaches like a college coach. You know, you think of a guy like John Wooden, Dean Smith. Everybody listens to what he has to say.
Lamar Odom and Omer Asik just about set to jump it up, and the gold medal game is underway in Istanbul.
Only 11 turnovers a game for Turkey. Team USA will try to put the pressure on.
This is Omer Asik. Was a bit of a controversial figure last night. We'll explain in a moment. Asik, first attempt won't go, and Durant clears the board.
Got an idea of Turkey's early strategy. Go inside to their size, but play inside-out basketball as well.
Derrick Rose getting off to a fast start, and that's big to get his confidence after a game last night in which he did not play the fourth quarter.
Only 12 minutes, 0 for 4. There was some speculation he'd be out of the lineup. Be crazy for Coach K to change, go away from Derrick Rose this late.
Vito Turkoglu, known as by one name, Hydeat. Here's Onan getting by Durant for the basket. Omer Onan, who had 14 points against Serbia yesterday. Rose looking to drive again, and a whistle called against Turkey. It's going to be hard to hear those whistles today as Onan picks up his first personal.
Two contrasting styles. You've got a coach in Tanjevic, very tough taskmaster. They have a very disciplined training program. Oh, boy.
Kevin Durant, who had 33 points in the quarterfinal win, and then topped that last night with a 38-point effort, has the first basket.
I talked to assistant coach at Turkey, Rolando Blackman, the former NBA star, and he said they cannot treat Durant like an average player.
Asik will get to the line as he is fouled. Last night, Omer Asik was a bit controversial because he got fouled late in the game. He's one of the worst free throw shooters in this tournament, and he actually stayed down and was not able to finish the game. They had another shooter come in.
Well, he was, and he miraculously recovered for the final. The coach of Serbia, Ivkovic, was not happy. He said, we've seen an example of unfair play. And responded to by Coach Tanjevic, he said, they murdered my guy.
Well, he came out of the game with an ice pack on the side of his head. Did not return. Turkey pulled out the win. That's a bonus when Asik hits one of two. He's missed 26 of his 41 free throws coming in. Here's Durant with the step away three, and that goes down. You can't defend that shot.
What a start for Kevin Durant. You know, one question I had coming in is, what happens if Kevin Durant has an off night? He's been that important for Team USA offensively.
Onan getting by Billups, who slipped, and the floater goes down for Omer Onan.
Well, the average fan back in the United States has not ever heard of these guards, but they're very experienced, Onan and Tuncheri.
How about Lamar Odom trying to take Asik? The loose change, Iguodala puts it down. What a tournament he has done, cleaning things up for the U.S. Had three big steals yesterday to get things turned around against Lithuania. Ersan Ilyasova, the Milwaukee Buck, fouled by Kevin Durant. Called for the hip. Fran, Turkey really needs a game out of Ersan Ilyasova.
Well, he struggled last night, but coming into this semifinals and now finals, he was shooting about 60% from behind the arc. He plays terrifically off Turkoglu because Turkoglu is the facilitator of this offense with his playmaking.
Ilyasova knocking down the first in his second tour in the NBA, back with Milwaukee. Took a couple of years, played at Barcelona. In fact, he was the first Turkish player ever to play for FC Barcelona. Did so for a couple of seasons. Back in the NBA, has had a great FIBA World Championship, except for last night's game in which Turkey was able to overcome his effort. Hidu Turkoglu was a little bit off yesterday as well.
There's the zone now. It's a matchup zone. They bring Asik high, so it's a 2-1-2 with a 7-footer in the middle.
And Kevin Durant, who cannot miss. What a start for Kevin Durant.
Said it a number of times, Mark. If you're drafting the best player in the world right now and you're looking for the next decade at 21 years old, I think you take Kevin Durant.
8 of the U.S. 12 points. Onan looking to take Billups to the basket. And Lamar Odom comes away with the loose ball. Last night, the Turkish fans were whistling all night long against Serbia, the European equivalent of boos. Derrick Rose has struggled from outside.
If Turkey stays in the zone, I think Coach K will go to Gordon or Westbrook. Westbrook did a great job of driving the zone last night.
Two guys that have become invaluable off the bench for the United States. Here's Turkoglu, and they need a big performance from him. Foul before that follow-up by Ilyasova. And Andre Iguodala is going to pick up the foul.
I thought last night, Mark, Turkey played with a lot of pressure on themselves against Serbia, knowing that they were the favorites. Sometimes when you play in front of this kind of home support, it can work against you if you squeeze the ball too tight, try to make the home run plays.
Fran, do you think that was maybe something good that comes out of it for Turkey? I mean, you would think this would be the game where they would tighten up, but they really escaped last night with a last-second win.
So often when you play in a pressure type of tournament atmosphere, one and done, once you get over the hump of a game where you struggle to win, it makes the next game a little bit easier, pressure-wise.
Lamar Odom's going to have to come out of the game as they attend to him. Got hit in that scrum, looked like Turkoglu might have got a piece. Tyson Chandler in the game, and Hidu Turkoglu at the free throw line. The silence is deafening here at the Olympic Dome in Turkey. Turkoglu has played with Sacramento, San Antonio, had the great run with Orlando, had a very off season with the Raptors last year, part of the Leandro Barbosa trade. He'll be playing for the Phoenix Suns. Training camp coming up at the end of the month.
See how high that zone comes out.
Down court for Onan. Great pass, but the basket won't go down.
I talked to Rolando Blackman today, and he said they were going to try to force USA to hit jump shots against the zone.
Chauncey Billups hammered as he went down the lane.
This is an example of how you attack the zone. Since Turkey spreads the zone out, it allows for dribble penetration. Billups, we've seen, has the strength to play in this kind of tournament.
Omer Asik picking up his first personal. Second team foul against Turkey, and Chauncey Billups, who we saw a little bit move over to the point guard late in the game against Lithuania. We'll keep an eye on that. Hits his first free throw. Billups, the senior member of this Team USA squad at age 33. Came off the bench with the qualifying team in 2007, looking to win himself a gold medal. Kerem Tunçeri, the point guard for Turkey.
Little 2-3 zone early by Team USA. Remember, this team shoots 43 from behind the arc.
Well designed, inside to Ilyasova, outside to Turkoglu. Turkey back within two. Tunçeri getting all over Billups. That ball off the foot of Onan. They'll put the shot clock at 24.
Rolando Blackman also told me he felt Lithuania treated Kevin Durant last night like a normal player. They were going to try to put a lot more pressure on Durant tonight.
Derrick Rose with a quick one-on-one shot. Doesn't go down. Turkey with a chance to tie or take the lead. Ilyasova, nice fake on Durant. Over Chandler, won't go. Billups guarded by Onan. Terrific defender for Turkey.
I think Kevin Durant may have caught that ball out of bounds on the sideline on that skip pass.
Rolando Blackman, the assistant coach for Turkey, former great Dallas Maverick.
He played for Coach Tanjevic after his NBA career in Italy. And in fact, Rolando Blackman was on the 1980 U.S. Olympic team that didn't get a chance to participate in Moscow.
Pass for Asik a little bit behind him. Eric Gordon on the floor for the first time for Team USA. Here's Billups dribbling into traffic.
They need to pass the ball and stretch the defense before they drive.
How about a long three for Durant? Little too long. But tipped out by Chandler and a whistle underneath. And they're going to call a loose ball foul on Tyson Chandler.
Right now, if you're Team USA, you must keep your composure, because even the officials will get caught up in this crowd. It's only human nature.
The officials from Brazil, Italy, and Spain for this gold medal match. That was team foul number 4 against the U.S., so Turkey will be in the bonus the rest of the way.
If Turkey wins, this game, then FIBA Europe will get an extra spot in the Olympics in 2012.
Turkoğlu from the corner has given the Turks the lead. 8 points for Hato Turkoğlu.
Team USA has got to put someone on the baseline because of the way Turkey has stretched their zone.
Eric Gordon has been the special weapon off the bench, not able to hit there. And a loose ball in the corner as Turkoğlu and Chandler have some words and have to be separated. And now the officials, both trying to restore order, telling both benches to sit down.
Now that's just a good acting job by Turkoğlu. Look at this. See, yeah, see Turkoğlu, you can see Turkoğlu started this, but he's smart. If he can bait Chandler into a silly foul, an unsportsmanlike conduct foul,
and there's the foul on Tyson Chandler, and there's going to be free throws here because Turkey
That's bad.
Is in the bonus.
Well, listen, I expected this. If you're Team USA right now, you must keep your cool. Take a look now. That's Turkoğlu all the way getting into Chandler's face. I've said from the beginning, FIBA officiating is inconsistent.
It's like they changed it.
Yes.
Foul on Turkoğlu.
I take it back. That's good officiating right there. Everybody in the building thought there was a foul on Chandler.
And now the Hato Turkoğlu having it out with the officials. Got to remember, we have three officials. One speaks Portuguese, one speaks Spanish, one Italian, trying to get things together. I'm sure English is the common language, but a good job by the officials to get it right. Eric Gordon. Nice pass for Odom, lost it on the way up. Turkey ran on high adrenaline in the victory against Serbia last night. And Osic's basket has them on their feet.
If you're Team USA, you must defend the pick and roll in transition. Look how high that zone has come out now. Turkey used this zone the whole tournament with great effect.
Kick ball out of bounds. We'll stay with the U.S. They'll reset the shot clock. Hato Turkoğlu continues to talk with the officials. Lamar Odom just below his eye getting patched up as Andre Iguodala comes out. Russell Westbrook checking in for the first time. Well, we expected a tough, tense, loud battle, and I believe we've got it. Well, we're still waiting for the crisp passing of the U.S. offense, loose ball out of bounds, and they'll say it goes to the Americans. Last touch by Ilyasova.
Ilyasova was trying to steal the call. The referee thought it went through Turkoglu's legs, and Ilyasova was going to let it go and try to steal that call. Right now, Mark, if you're Team USA, strategically, because the zone is extended out to the wings, the baseline is open. And if you can get somebody like Odom, who's acted effectively down there throughout this tournament, you're going to be able to get behind the zone.
Turkoğlu headed to the bench. They're checking him out after that tumble on the loose ball. Westbrook, long rebound. Durant's been pushed way outside and hits an NBA length three-pointer.
Well, much like we've seen in the quarterfinals against Russia and then again last night against Lithuania, Kevin Durant has been red hot.
And he just silenced 15,000 Turks. He's hit 4 of 5. And leads the way with 11. Steal. And he's fouled. Good foul. They had one to give. It's ESPN Sunday Night Baseball tonight. The Cardinals will take on the Braves. Sunday Night Baseball presented by Taco Bell, part of Lee Jean's The Hunt for October on ESPN and ESPN3.com. Coming up at 8 o'clock Eastern Time, Tim Hudson will go for his 16th win. Braves and Phillies still tied atop the NL East. Great finish to baseball and a great finish to the FIBA World Championship.
Three-guard offense now. Steph Curry in the game.
Curry, Westbrook, and Gordon, the three guards on the floor. Pass for Odom, didn't see it. Down court, Onan. Durant went for the block. I think Onan just missed it, knowing Durant was behind him.
Durant taking a chance with that first foul, but a terrific play.
Curry behind the screen. Steph Curry coming up with a big three-pointer off Coach K's bench.
Well, right now, our freelance offense has been very good because we're making shots.
Well, in this tournament so far, it has been the defense which has really turned it for the U.S., turning steals into baskets.
Arcelon is very quick.
Elias Silva fakes out Durant. His shot might have been deflected.
Oh, he walked.
Well, they'll call a 24-second violation on Gunloom. After that shot missed everything, clock wound down. Yeah, Durant looked like he just got a piece. What a tournament he has had.
Coach K has gone to three guards. Turkey has a big front line. There's a mismatch on the offensive end for Turkey. But Coach K has his best two shooters out there in Curry and Durant.
Eric Gordon's drive slapped away. U.S. will keep it with 16 to shoot. Gunloom getting a hand on that one.
Turkey makes it very tough to get the ball in, Mark.
So much length. Offensive foul against Russell Westbrook on the reach around.
Take a look now as Westbrook hooks, coming out of the corner. An easy call.
Ender Arcelan leading the Turkey offense. And when they trailed Serbia last night, he was one of the spark plugs off the bench. 1 minute to go in the first. Gordon all over him. Runs into his own player with six to shoot. This is Goulart. Three to shoot. He's not going to get a shot off as Eric Gordon defended him beautifully.
We've talked about this throughout the tournament. That's what you call defensive patience. They guarded the pick and roll. It became a one-on-one situation. Eric Gordon held his ground.
Timeout on the floor. Turkey calls time. The U.S. has the lead, 49.4 to go, and the U.S. bench loving what they see. If they can pull off the gold medal, it'll be defense that doesn't form in this tournament.
Well, what you love about Team USA so far, second 24-second violation in this quarter. Their pressure defense out front is the key.
Kevin Durant in the semifinals, 38 points, 9 rebounds. He hit 14 field goals, which broke Dwayne Wade's record and Carmelo Anthony and three others. And he came into this game just 6 points shy of Luther Burden's U.S. World Championship record after that 38-point night and 11 more so far tonight. He now is the all-time scorer in a World Championship tournament for the U.S.
Luther Tiki Burden, who played at Utah and then a cup of coffee in the NBA. But the thing I worry about if I'm Team USA is if Durant picks up a second foul or gets in foul trouble or has the off night, who else is going to pick up this offense?
There's a question that the United States does not want to know if they have to answer. We'll keep an eye if they do. Maybe it would be Rudy Gay from the corner.
See, good. They're just shading Durant right now, and Team USA has got to be more patient on the offensive end.
There's Son Ilya Silva against Kevin Durant. Skying for the rebound is Rudy Gay.
Keep your eye on that zone, and wherever Kevin Durant is, number five, take a look at how they shade to him.
Sinan Goulart, number five in white, an in-your-shorts defender for Turkey. Six to shoot for the U.S. Taking it toward the rim. And a foul underneath against Turkey.
The opportunist, Russell Westbrook, he averages 5 rebounds a game for the Oklahoma City Thunder. And we've seen him come up with a bunch of hustle rebounds in this World Championship.
First personal on Ender Arslan will send Russell Westbrook to the free throw line. Averaging almost 9 points a game in this World Championship. At 12.7 boards, 3 assists in the win against Lithuania. He and Kevin Durant be heading back to Oklahoma City. And big expectations now for the Thunder Ball Club. Down court. And the U.S. and the U.S. bench loving what they see in the first quarter. 22-17 in the gold medal game after one. U.S. up 5 after one, but Hidu Turkoglu, they need him in the lineup, and right now he is, looks like that right knee is injured.
They put a brace on him. The coaching staff looked down to him. He said he's ready to go. It's a matter of Coach Tanjevic going back with him.
Start of the second quarter, Eric Gordon missing on the three-pointer. Last touch by Turkey. Kevin Durant, 11 points in the first quarter, hit 3 threes. Second chance points were big, 7-0 in favor of the USA and a 5-point lead after one.
I think right now USA is playing with fire in terms of shooting the ball so quickly. And watch how Turkey makes it. They overload to this ball side. They make it very tough to throw the ball in if you don't have a zone inbound play.
Aram Gunalem and the big arms in front of Curry. That pass deflected, but Gordon comes up with it. Westbrook exploding to the lane, and he'll go to the line.
If you shade Kevin Durant in the zone, then you're basically playing 4-on-4, and you're going to allow the quickness and strength of Westbrook to get to the rim. He has been their most effective penetrator against zones in this tournament.
Ersan Ilyasova picking up the foul is first, and a 3-point play for Russell Westbrook, who came to Las Vegas 3 or 4 weeks ago, kind of a long shot to make this team, and how valuable has he been for the United States in this run?
And as well as Eric Gordon, who's out on the court right now, as people expected Rajon Rondo to be out there.
Arslan finding a seam, and a whistle as he got down.
The difficulty out top for Steph Curry right now is if he forces the ball to the screen, it creates indecision on the part of his teammate. If he forces away from the screen, you're allowing Arslan, the quickest player on Turkey, to get a running start at the rim. That's a tough assignment.
Ender Arslan, who, like many of the Turkish national players, play right here professionally in Istanbul, part of the Efes Pilsen team.
It's a good point. Remember, Turkey is playing without Engin Atsur, who is a solid point guard here in the TBL, the Turkish Basketball League, who played at NC State, and without Mehmet Okur of the Utah Jazz, recovering from an Achilles tendon injury.
Two missed free throws by Arslan and a loose ball foul against Turkey on the rebound.
It's okay because he made the ones that he needed to make last night when he replaced Omer Asik late in that game. Watch how far out that zone is stretched, and they shade to Durant. See, Goulart is shading to Durant.
And a travel call on Rudy Gay. You know, we haven't seen a lot of those calls late in the tournament as all the teams, especially the U.S., who doesn't see that kind of call, but a big one there. Fourth turnover for the U.S. Ilyasova knocking down Curry and then getting the easy shot.
Now the decision, if you're Mike Krzyzewski, is do you leave Curry out for his shooting or do you take him out, because with a three-guard lineup, he becomes a problem defensively.
Tough angled shot for Rudy Gay, and he knocks down a two-pointer. The United States getting 10 points off its bench.
There's the switch and the mismatch inside.
Erden and Curry, about 8 inches difference. Arsalan, the no-look pass. Gonlum had it poked away by Westbrook. And they won't get a shot off. Another great defensive stand for the U.S. That's the third time the 24-second shot clock's gone off against Turkey.
The second time that Westbrook has been mismatched against the bigger guy, that he's poked the ball away. They tried to go size on quickness, and quickness won out.
See Arsalan frustrated. The backup point guard for Turkey. Chauncey Billups in the game, and he is at the point, Fran. Long three-pointer. He wanted a foul call.
Well, he got his arm taken off. The referee was out of position, couldn't see it.
Under 8 minutes to go in the half. Steal by Gay, but he landed on the end line, on the sideline. It'll go back to Turkey. You know, it's not often, Fran, that a team wins a world championship at home. In fact, it rarely ever happens that a team will play on its home floor for a world championship. But it's been 40 years. Yugoslavia in 1970, and Turkey has a chance to do it.
Well, they won that tournament in Ljubljana, which is now the capital of Slovenia.
Yugoslavia won 5 gold medals, the former Yugoslavia. That's a record at the World Championships. U.S. has 3, looking for number 4. Tuncheri, who's had a quiet first half, missing the shot there. U.S. has not won a gold medal at the World Championships since 1994.
Look how they shade Durant on the weak side. That time they left him open.
Tuncheri hit hard by Rudy Gay. The fans are going to want an unsportsmanlike foul, but I don't think they're going to get it. Foul on Rudy Gay, his first.
We saw this in the first game with Serbia's players up off the bench, and in this game, the entire bench came out towards midcourt, something that wouldn't be allowed in the NBA or college basketball.
The coach of Turkey, Boyan Tanjevic, trying to bring his players back to the bench area. We've got a timeout on the floor. We'll be back to Istanbul. 2010 FIBA World Championship. Russell Westbrook, part of the bench that has put up 10 United States points to none for Turkey. Fred Fraschilla, I'm Mark Kestisher. As the U.S. looks to finish off an impressive run with a very young team. Kerem Tuncheri, the hero last night for Turkey. The layup half a second ago gets the Turks to within 7.
That's a 2-1-2 zone now. Osik comes way out. It's really the equivalent of 1-3-1.
Tough pass for Durant to handle. Loose off the steal. Goulart on the baseline drive. Reverse. And a foul will go against Goulart. And a look at Boyan Tanjevic. And Fran, there's really 2 different styles of coaching we're seeing here tonight.
Well, you're right. You know, when you look at Coach Tanjevic, it's a college atmosphere. He's the father figure. Very tough training camp. In fact, Rolando Blackman told me he treats these guys, it's like feeding a flower. You want them to blossom at the right time. Very, very intense. Coach K, on the other hand, keep them fresh. Let them play. Keep the offenses simple. 2 different ways, 2 successful ways.
Look at Rolando Blackman, the great former Dallas Maverick, part of this Turkish coaching staff.
You know Rolando, very intense guy. I talked to him this afternoon on the phone, and you could hear the passion come through his voice. He said, it's not David and Goliath. If we play well, we can win this game.
Lamar Odom got called for a loose ball foul a second. Hito Turkoglu back on the floor at the point forward and just missing on that jumper. Gonlum trying to save it on the end line, does so. And Osik is held underneath, which is not a terrible foul. apologize for issues with our score and game clock. Will keep you apprised. 6:14 to go in the half. U.S. with a 27-21 lead as Andre Iguodala picks up his second personal, team foul number four. So the U.S. now at the limit. Little zone action by the U.S. Nice pass from big man to big man. Osick, that will not count. Traveling violation on Omer Osick.
Well, Andre Iguodala came from the back of Osick and got the block. Well executed high-low versus the zone. Iguodala making up with that athleticism. Take a look. That's a great pass and a great anticipation.
Durant hit hard by Osick. He hits the deck.
Well, what you love about Kevin Durant right now, and he's down, is that he's admitted that he's learned to play through contact in this tournament.
And Kevin Durant slow to get up on the baseline as Osick picks up his second foul.
Now, unlike Omer Osick, who stayed down for an eternity last night until they were able to get a extra free throw shooter in, Kevin Durant knocking down 30 of 32 from the line.
Kevin Durant going to walk it off. Lamar Odom will trail him. Durant's been the scoring hero for the U.S., 22.1 points per game. That's third in the tournament so far. Hardly ever misses at the free throw line. 30 of 32 coming in, shaking off the cobwebs. These are his first free throws of the night. Dead center. Well, he's already broken the U.S. scoring single game record in a world championship. He now owns the world championship tournament record for the U.S. and has a chance to have the best average points per game in a world championship. And a rare free throw miss. The ref says play on. Tuncheri tried to make one extra pass. Erden was already making his way toward the basket, off his hands out of bounds. And Auguste Savage will check in as Gonlum sits down.
Savage is a guy very crafty, shoots the ball at a high rate inside. Dangerous from the three-point line as well.
Durant hits the corner three, and Kevin Durant has given the United States a 10-point lead.
Erden is a big guy who's used to playing in the paint. Savage in the middle meant Erden had to play the corner, and he lost sight of Durant. Bad move.
Kevin Durant with his fourth three-pointer of the evening. 15 points as he covers Hedo Turkoglu. Tuncheri way outside. Fight for the loose ball. Last touch by Turkey, and the fans can't believe it. Goulaire, the last to touch.
Well, you'd have to say the officiating has been inconsistent, fair, good, whatever, both ways. Team USA has gotten some calls.
Rose on the pitch out is fouled on his way in. And Uz Savash will pick up that personal.
That's see Derek, his first. Yeah, Derek Rose with that quickness versus the zone.
Chauncey Billups against the much taller Erden will launch for three. In and out for Chauncey Billups. Turkey down 10, trying to quicken the pace. Savage. Much bigger than Durant. Another pass for Erden knocked away. A little careless basketball for Turkey now. That's their ninth turnover.
Turkey's got to get used to the quickness of Team USA.
Derrick Rose continues to struggle with his shot. U.S. getting another possession. Iguodala for three. Well, outside of Kevin Durant, the rest of the team struggling from outside the FIBA three-point line. 1 of 9. Durant's 4 of 7. Turkoglu.
Well, you talk about a jab step. Little jab step, got the 6-3 rose off him, created separation. And shot that three like it was at 3 o'clock at practice.
Ido Turkoglu with 11 points to get Turkey within 7. Kevin Durant will launch another three and hit another three. He's got 5, and he's got the Turkish coaches wondering what they got to do to defend him.
Well, it's exactly what they talked about before the game. You cannot treat him normally. Even if you don't play a box and one on him, take one guy and put him on Durant. Make somebody else beat you.
Kevin Durant with 18 points.
Here's that mismatch again.
Savage. Tip will go down.
Boy, that could have been basket interference. That ball might have hit Savage's hands before it hit the rim.
Durant, quick shot from 14, goes down. Unstoppable from the three-point line, from the free throw line, and from the inside. 20 of the U.S. 36 from Durant.
That's the shooter at the top of the key. They run good stuff.
Find Erden and a left-handed dunk. And a foul at midcourt against Goulart. Are you ready for some football? Monday Night Football kicking off tomorrow. A doubleheader. First at 7 Eastern time, the Ravens and the Jets. First regular season Monday Night Football game from the new Meadowlands Stadium, and then at 10:15 Eastern, the four-time defending AFC West champion San Diego Chargers take on the Chiefs, and our coverage beginning Monday night, 5 Eastern, Monday Night Countdown, served by Applebee's.
The physicality in those two games Monday night will have nothing on this basketball game. It's almost too physical, Mark, really. FIBA play is generally more physical than the NBA because they've outlawed hand-checking out top. But both ways, it's too physical to play this way.
You got the feeling that both teams just trying to work one another before the game. There's a lot of staring, no smiling, trying to intimidate each other. And Chauncey Billups with the U.S. in the bonus, hitting 2 free throws, a 10-point lead.
Well, Chauncey Billups has been a security blanket for this young team. He and Lamar Odom have been very, very valuable, and you know, not just with their leadership, they've played very well.
They've been the security blanket, Kevin Durant.
That should be an over and back. I don't think Durant touched it. Durant did not touch that basketball. That ball was not touched, I don't believe. We'll get a chance to see the replay. Hard to tell from that angle. From where we saw it, it looked like it missed Durant. Now he's not very demonstrative, so it may have deflected off his fingers. He's got the 7'5 wingspan.
And that's the ruling from the officials. It'll be sideline out for Turkey with 10 on the shot clock. As Kerem Tuncheri brings it up against Gordon. The slip for Savas. Lost the handle, but a whistle as Savas was making his way down the lane. Eric Gordon will pick it up.
When you talk about the pick and roll in international basketball, there's the foul right there by Gordon. You know, it's not just Team USA that struggled guarding that. The reason the pick and roll is so effective is because when you have players that can operate offensively as man with the ball or the screener, it creates a lot of indecision on the part of not only the two defenders guarding, but the other three defenders who have to decide when and where to help from.
He's been one of the Achilles heels for the United States defense in this tournament.
Really not many, but that's probably the only one. Their defense has been very, very good throughout this tournament.
Gordon will try the three ball. Well, the rest of the U.S. team, 1 of 11 from three. Kevin Durant's 5 of 8. Carrying them in the first half. Turkey down 9. Savas draws contact and he'll get to the line for 2. Chauncey Billups will pick that one up.
Turkey knows now that Team USA is caught in a lot of switches. So once they recognize the mismatch, they're going right at the weakness.
We've seen some big front lines in this World Championship. Turkey is very long. Good skill players at a big size. Savas getting some extra minutes here toward the end of the first half.
And if you double those big guys inside, Turkey shoots at a high rate from behind the three-point line, 43% coming in. This is a perfect example of playing the game from inside out.
The U.S., big favorite getting to the gold medal game. Turkey's got the crowd and some good momentum. They've kept it a single-digit game. Eight to shoot, Gordon will. Here's Savas off the window, no good. Coming up on a minute to go, first half of the gold medal game. Billups missing badly to the right, but the loose ball put in by Rudy Gay.
Rudy Gay has accepted his role as a garbage man on that second unit. He's a scorer in Memphis, but his agility and quickness has made him very effective on the backboards in this tournament.
45 seconds to go in the half. Savas. Nice job by Rudy Gay.
Play it smart here. If you're USA, you can get two for one.
Tip, Westbrook won't go down. Turkey running. Onan from the corner. Ilyasova keeps it alive, draws the foul, and he'll go to the line for two. Eric Gordon picking up the personal.
Well, the quickness of the three guards has been pretty good, but it can also affect you on the backboards.
Timeout on the floor, still 24.8 seconds to go. In the first half, Team USA up 9 in Istanbul. One half of basketball remaining in Istanbul. It's the 2010 FIBA World Championship. And at the half, Team USA with a 42-32 lead over Turkey. And we welcome you back inside the Olympic Dome. You can see the Naismith Trophy right in front of Fran Fraschilla. I'm Mark Kestisher, and that's what these teams have been fighting for 2 weeks. Kevin Durant well on his way toward an MVP for this tournament.
He's been unbelievable. 5 of 9 from three. He's done it on the defensive end. We said from the very beginning, and Coach K said it, they would have to put this team on his back. He's done it offensively, but he's also made some terrific defensive plays as well. So key for Team USA now is everyone else is 1 for 13 from behind the arc. You got to hope Kevin Durant stays hot. You got to look for some offense from somebody else.
And on the defensive end, as we look at Kevin Durant's numbers, he's come up with the 20 points. 5 of 9 from three-point range. Hedo Turkoglu also helping out Team Turkey to stay close in this one.
Well, the other thing, too, now, when you talk about Team USA, outstanding first-half defense. Turkey only shooting 35% from the arc, and from inside the arc, by the way, and also 10 turnovers. They only average 11 in the tournament.
Just about set for the start of the second half. The U.S. two quarters away from its first gold medal at the World Championship since 1994. They come out running for Turkoglu, misses on the layup attempt. U.S. quick down court. Nice save by Rose on the baseline. Rose drives into Osick, who gets the block. 10 to shoot. With 4, Rose. And the U.S. will get another possession. Billups, a quick trigger.
Boy, the 3 has been so effective in this tournament for Team USA. Hanging around that 40% mark. But tonight, 1 for 14 from behind the arc for everybody but Kevin Durant.
It has been one of the main storylines here in Istanbul. Kevin Durant has carried the offense. The defense has been terrific for Team USA. A near steal by Durant. That's going to be a 4th 24-second shot clock violation as we talk U.S. defense.
Well, Mark, you know, I've said this from the beginning of the tournament. When you play these type of teams that run continuity offenses and move the ball, You must have patience for all 24 seconds. One stop on a possession is not enough. You got to defend pick and roll, then defend a screen down, and then you got to play one-on-one at the end of the clock.
Derrick Rose with a look over to Coach Krzyzewski.
Turkey's gone to a big lineup. Turkoglu at the two. That makes the zone that much bigger.
Durant, he's been the only guy hitting threes, and he continues.
I don't know if it was by design, but he moved into the area where the 6'2 Tuncheri was.
That's his sixth three-pointer of the evening. Absolutely took the air out of this building.
The first 3 minutes are crucial for Team USA. If they can open up a big lead, it'll pay dividends because you know Turkey's got a run or two in them.
Kevin Durant feeling it and knocking it down again, and a look to the Turkish fans. And I don't believe they appreciated that too much. Kevin Durant, 26 points. 7 3-pointers. Team USA up 16 early. Kevin Durant with 26 points, a couple of more threes. Fran, when you think about Kevin Durant, this might be the most pressure he has faced since turning pro.
Well, there's no question, and that's what the Oklahoma City Thunder coaching staff and personnel people felt about this. This would give him an opportunity to not only grow as a scorer, he led the league in scoring as a 21-year-old, but as a leader.
He's got the last 7 field goals or threes. Ilyasova thought he got fouled. U.S. pushing, and Derrick Rose was fouled before that pass and subsequent missed dunk by Andre Iguodala.
Watch the run out and then the foul. Keeps USA out of transition. Mark, it's been the half-court defense. They've contested shots. They've been patient. They've run that clock down on Turkey's offense. And they've rebounded the ball reasonably well.
Second foul on Arsalan, who gives Rose a lot of room. He's going to let him take that shot all night as he has continued to struggle from the perimeter.
Well, they're baiting everybody on Team USA to shoot the ball except Kevin Durant. That was the strategy coming in.
Kevin Durant, 26 points. All the records at the tournament. He set the single-game world championship record for the U.S. He's got the most points ever in a world championship. And he's going to have the highest average as well for the U.S. Arsalan lost it. Another great defensive effort by the U.S. Onan gets a hand in. Will they get it across the line? They do. Rose.
Boy, look at Lamar Odom. All tournament. All tournament. He's done the dirty work. 30 years old, out of Queens, New York. Got a couple of NBA titles. I don't think he's gotten enough credit in this tournament for all the little things he's done.
He has worked hard on defense, both sides of the glass. Trying to add to his chest. He's got those 2 world championships with the Lakers. As Arsalan knocks down a 3. Odom's got the bronze medal in Athens, and he wants gold. That 3 gets Turkey within 15.
Look where they play Derrick Rose.
Offensive foul on Derrick Rose as Arsalan draws the charge.
Arsalan ran away from Rose. Look how far he backed off. And then Rose just takes it at him. Usually you can get a running start when a player plays off you, but you got to have your head up.
Second foul on Derrick Rose. And the Turkish fans come alive. Onan feeding Asik on the block. Asik gets it back. Out of bounds. Turkey will keep it. Onan's looking for contact. This Turkish team right now is looking for a foul.
Hey, both teams have mugged each other all night, really. I felt this game was too physical from the start. Both ways. Got to watch Ilyasova and Onan from behind the arc versus the zone.
Long 3 attempt. Arsalan in and out. Iguodala looks to start a break. Here's Durant. Great passing. Durant for another three.
Oh, look at that hustle by Iguodala.
And the feed for Lamar Odom.
Iguodala and Odom quietly have done all the garbage work for this team. That's why they've been in the starting lineup for all of this tournament.
Coming up on 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Onan fouled on his way up. Are you ready for some football? Monday Night Football kicking off tomorrow. ESPN doubleheader starting at 7 Eastern. The Jets and the Ravens from the Meadowlands. And then at 10:15 Eastern, the Chargers will take on the Chiefs. I know we're in Istanbul, but I heard Sean Merriman doubtful with the injured Achilles for San Diego. Coverage beginning 5 Eastern. Monday Night Countdown served by Applebee's.
Let's see how much energy Russell Westbrook now brings to this lineup. One of the things that you like about this team and how it's evolved is Mike Krzyzewski has a nice rotation. And when you can bring fresh players like Rudy Gay, Westbrook, and Eric Gordon off the bench, it's provided an energy lift.
Turkey has had the crowd. The U.S. has consistently quieted them. Underneath, Iguodala knocked away out of bounds. It goes to Turkey.
Interesting matchup. Coach Tanyavich has taken the 6'9", Kerem Gonlum, who's a power forward and a dirty work guy, and they're going to try him on Durant.
Well, he has been very animated as Kevin Durant has hit three after three. Trying to get these guys to stop him. Nothing has worked so far. Onan getting inside. He'll get to the line for two. Chauncey Billups going to pick up his third personal foul.
Not a lot of contact there, but you see how Onan tried to drive his body into Billups. Billups tried to avoid him.
Chauncey Billups going to head out. So will Lamar Odom. Eric Gordon back on the floor with Rudy Gay for Team USA. That was the fourth team foul of the quarter, so Turkey in the bonus the rest of the third. Quite an atmosphere here in Istanbul. Very rare a host team gets to play in the championship. And quite a day in Turkey as well. September 12th, the 30th anniversary of the coup d'etat, the military taking over the government, had a huge referendum vote today. Whether they voted yes or no, they're all in accord for Team Turkey tonight. Rudy Gay inside. And Ilyasova takes it away. His pass deflected, but Gonlum has it. They need a big three from Arsalan, and they get it. And off the made basket, Coach Krzyzewski calling timeout. Turkey's got it down to 11. 4:07 to go, third quarter. Rest assured, Team USA's lead is at 11 with 4:07 left in the third.
And you look at this USA team right now, no center. Rudy Gay or Durant is the five, but very little playoff experience out there for Team USA.
Turkey looking to cut further into the lead. Semih Erden, did he step on the end line? He did. Turnover, Turkey. That's their 13th of the evening.
Right now, if you're Team USA, you must settle down versus this token pressure. And you have to get stops on the defensive end in order to increase this lead. See, Gonlum, big guy, he's holding Durant.
Almost mugging him.
Yes. It's good strategy by the coach because nothing else has worked in this tournament for anybody.
Kerem Gonlum picking up his first personal foul. Second team foul against Turkey in the third.
Turkey coaching staff told me today that yesterday Lithuania treated Durant like a normal player and he scored enough for two players.
I think Turkey has seen enough from him tonight. Rudy Gay hitting a big rainbow jumper after taking a finger to the eye.
Now, if you're Team USA, it's been defensive patience that's gotten you this lead. Can you continue to defend the 24-second clock?
And with this lineup, Fran, they're even faster on defense, you would think.
Their quickness in terms of their hands has really been a bother to Turkey.
Herden against Gay. Stripped and fouled.
See, that's where Rudy Gay tries for the steal. You're almost better off going hands to the ceiling on that and making Herden hit a tough shot.
Second foul on Rudy Gay. Sending Semi Herden to the free throw line. The 60th and final pick of the 2008 NBA draft. Been playing here in Istanbul with Fenerbahce, but headed to the Boston Celtics. Well, he had missed 10 free throws of his 31 in the World Championships, missing a big one there. The Turkish fans treated to one of the great international competitions last night, a one-point win over Serbia to reach this championship game. And all of Turkey here in the arena and around the country tuned in. Herden missing both free throws, and Westbrook hustles over for the loose ball. And again, using their fouls, that's only the third team foul of the quarter for Turkey.
Once again, Russell Westbrook coming up with a hustle rebound.
Third foul on Russell Westbrook. You gotta foul hard to get called for a foul in FIBA, folks. Westbrook against Herden. And Ilyasova pulls it down. Turkey right on the edge there, 13 points.
Team USA has a team right now that can do a lot of switching.
Ilyasova over Rudy Gay. And Durant, who's playing in the center spot right now, hauling down that rebound.
See, they're begging Russell Westbrook to shoot.
He does, and he scores, and a shake of the head from Russell Westbrook, who hits a big three.
Russell Westbrook is not without confidence. We've seen that in his tournament. His athleticism has been overwhelming at times.
That's only his second three-pointer of the entire World Championship. Onan to Ilyasova, who finds his way underneath for a layup. Seven for the Milwaukee Bucks forward.
See, I'd run off Westbrook one more time. I'd make him shoot another jump shot if I were Turkey.
Instead, it'll be Durant, and buries it with a man in his face.
Well, they switched out, and Arsalan, unfortunately for Turkey, was left trying to guard Kevin Durant.
28 points
and
tonight.
Quietly, Mark, they've come within the flow of the offense.
Onan trying to answer for Turkey.
Excellent contest by Eric Gordon. The underrated thing about Team USA's defense tonight is how they've been able to get to shooters and contest shots.
Westbrook, not that time.
Yep, see, they baited him. I would do it again. I would play off Westbrook if I were Turkey.
Same kind of game Turkey played against Derrick Rose when he was on the
Absolutely.
Floor.
Absolutely. Make someone else beat you.
Herden gets nice position. He'll get to the line. A chance at a three-point play.
Now they got buried inside. I talked about getting... They switch a lot, Team USA. Herden really the only guy inside right now for Turkey that can pound you.
That's two fouls on Russell Westbrook. Well, the scoreboard has certainly kept the Turkish fans quiet. This is arguably the toughest atmosphere the U.S. has faced in international competition since they played Greece in Athens 6 years ago. This arena has not been this quiet in 2 weeks. Last night, I don't think the chants or the screams of the Turkish fans ever stopped against Serbia. Almost. Kevin Durant, a large reason why they haven't been going all night.
Turkey went triangle in two, but Herden stepped out to help on Durant, and Odom slipped to the rim. Excellent execution. Good heads-up play.
Nice find by Derrick Rose. U.S. up 15.
See, the switch now puts Rose on Erden. They're trying to get Odom back.
Arsalan, tip, Gunlum.
Arsalan threw the ball over the back, over the rim, knowing that Gunlum had the advantage on Gordon inside.
Seconds to go in the third quarter of the gold medal game. Erden wants a piece of Durant. Six to shoot and a U.S. turnover. Ninth turnover for Team USA. Final shot of the quarter will go to Turkey.
Ilyasova's open.
Shoots over Durant for three, but he comes up short over that long arm. 4 seconds to go. Derrick Rose for three. The U.S. 10 minutes from gold. Kevin Durant has 28 as Istanbul awaits a winner. Back in Istanbul with Fran Fraschilla, I'm Mark Kestisher. While Kevin Durant's having a big game, Hedo Turkoglu not getting a lot of action in the third quarter.
He's only played 3 minutes this quarter. He hurt his knee in the first half, but he has a look of disgust down there, and the coaching staff, we're right in front of them. They seem disgusted with him. Be interesting to see how Coach Tanyevich plays him down a stretch.
The lob on the first U.S. possession of the fourth quarter, out of bounds. Turnover for the U.S. Finishing the Turkoglu story, had 8 points in that first quarter, and after that injury, only 3 points since. U.S. with a 13-point lead. Erden against Odom. Ilyasova got a paw on it, but Westbrook comes away finding Rose down court, and Rose will throw it down.
Once again, solid half-court defense. Kevin Durant, Lamar Odom inside. Their length, maybe not the physical strength, but their length is bothering Turkey inside. I'll tell you, if there's an all-tournament team,
as Arsalan launches a long three and misses.
Lamar Odom's not going to be on the all-tournament team, but he's been as valuable as anybody besides Kevin Durant in this tournament.
How about Derrick Rose after the dunk? Comes in from the left side and lays it in. Four quickies for Derrick Rose.
Team USA defense, Mark, outstanding all night long. And it's been three guards and two forwards for this second half.
There's been a lot of big teams in this tournament, including this Turkish team, but if you're fast and quick, doesn't matter your size. Erden that time, getting inside for the basket. Fans get loud again inside the Sinan Erdem Dome in Istanbul.
Gonlum again wrestling with Durant. They've done a nice job on Durant.
Four to shoot for Chauncey. Phillips the move. One to shoot. Lamar Odom for three, and he knocks it down, beating the shot clock.
That's clutch. That's his range, too. That's a mid-range jumper. About 20 feet, 6 inches behind the arc in FIBA play. 3 feet closer than the NBA line.
And a whistle up high. Chauncey Billups is going to be his fourth personal with 7:33 to go in the fourth quarter.
And Chauncey's had a very good tournament. Quicker guys have bothered him on occasion, but overall, his contribution to this team has been outstanding.
News and notes from the tournament. Of course, Team USA, it's been 16 years since they've won gold. Turkey's been a huge story getting to the finals. And in Istanbul, looking to pull off the upset, but now down 18. They'll wave off the shot, the foul, before Erden puts up his shot. Lamar Odom going to pick up number three.
If I'm Coach K, I don't mind them working Erden on Odom because it's taken Turkey out of their rhythm. Now Turkoglu is back.
As is Kerem Tuncheri, number 10.
Donovan is not a shooter. Doesn't even look to shoot outside the paint.
Lost the handle on the way up thanks to Lamar Odom, who continues to get it done. And Odom puts it in. Lamar Odom, scoreless first half, now has 11 points so far in the second half as Team USA goes up 20.
The B team.
I think the B team might be getting an A+.
Well, Jim Boeheim told me a couple weeks ago he thought this team was better defensively than the team in 08 that won the gold.
Big shot for Hedo Turkoglu. A deep two for Turkoglu. Turkey's going to need to force some turnovers. Derrick Rose will go to the line. A flurry of offense from the Chicago Bulls point guard. Semi Erden picking up his second personal foul. Well, you like to see that. You know, we know about the redeem team, but Derrick Rose redeeming himself here during the knockout round.
Played only 12 minutes last night, 0 for 4. And the quickness of this backcourt, particularly Westbrook and Gordon. Excuse me, Rose.
Friend, the thing you love about Rose, as much as perhaps some people watching from afar were disappointed, and Lamar Odom with nobody to box him out just puts in the missed free throw.
One of the things about the FIBA lane, the trapezoid lane, is the second man on the lane, Mark, the offensive player, is actually closer to the middle of the floor than the defender, and Lamar Odom took advantage of that right there.
And in international men's play, this is the last game with the trapezoid lane.
We've been over to Vestikas, the arena over there, and they already have the rectangular lane down. October 1st, they'll change the rules.
Tuncheri for three, hits. Vestikas, the area of Istanbul. We've been staying in, Team USA has been staying in and practicing in. Team USA has already checked out of the Four Seasons. They'll have a little celebration, they hope, in 5.5 minutes and make their way back to the United States. U.S. turnover with 5.5 minutes to go. That's turnover number 10. Nice feed inside for Gonlum. Karen Gonlum scoring for Turkey.
Look for a timeout from Coach K. The coach can make. He's the only person on the floor that can signal for timeout and has to come after a dead ball.
Lamar Odom left open and shoots a lefty mid-range jumper.
Boy, how good has he been? You think those two world championships don't pay off in a situation like this?
15 points for Lamar Odom. The U.S. 4.5 minutes away from restoring gold in the World Championships. And Erden fouled hard as he tried to up fake. Let's take a look at the differences between the FIBA rules and the NBA rules.
Well, we know about the game being shorter, 40 minutes versus 48. Of course, the trapezoid lane. The thing that I like about FIBA basketball, Mark, is that the coach can't call timeout. Cannot call timeout while the ball is in play, and that pays dividends for a well-coached team late in the ball game.
We got a timeout in Istanbul. 4:35 from gold for the U.S.
Now I'll turn it over to the Gecko.
Ah, thank you, sir. As we all know, GEICO has been saving people money on RV, camper, and trailer insurance, as well as motorcycle insurance. Ah, sorry. Technical difficulties.
What about this?
What's this one do? Maybe that one.
Okay, let's keep rolling. We run motorcycle insurance?
Take 15 minutes to see how much you could save on motorcycle, RV, and camper insurance. We'll be right back.
The medals are on the floor. You see the gold medals, the silver, and the bronze. And if the U.S. can hang on the next 4:35 with a big lead, they'll have those gold medals. But this means more than just winning the gold in the World Championship for Team USA.
Exactly. The winner of the World Championship gets an automatic bid to the 2012 Olympics. I'm sure all those NBA guys will appreciate having the summer off. I'm sure they'll have a training camp just to stay sharp for a few days. But this team, if they hang on, will reconvene in the summer of 2012. And the interesting thing, Mark, there'll be 24 champions fighting for 12 spots, the 12 guys that were on the gold medal team in 2008. And the 12 players who are on this roster right here.
Mike Krzyzewski was asked a couple of days ago, how difficult will it be to make choices based on the 12 who played in Beijing, opted not to come to the World Championships, and now you'll have 12 more gold medal winners. Obviously, LeBron James and Dwayne Wade and Carmelo Anthony and Kobe Bryant and Kevin Durant, you would think is a no-brainer. Andre Iguodala fouled on the reverse try. .416 left in the gold medal game. The U.S. in front of Turkey 76-57. And, you know, this is what the U.S. was up against with none of their gold medal winners coming back. And it's been a very young team for Coach Krzyzewski.
Six players under the age of 22. When you compare this team to the gold medal team in 08, who had 53 all-star appearances, this team only has 8. And they had something to prove. We saw that in training camp in Las Vegas and in New York. I think, Mark, the best thing about this team has been its outstanding defense.
Outside of Kevin Durant, who would be the number two guy on this team that you'd say is a lock for 12?
Boy, that's a great question. I would have said Derrick Rose early in this tournament. You know, that's going to be really interesting. I mean, Lamar Odom, you know, he'll be 32. Maybe one of those guys that is the veteran presence.
Osik with the dunk for Turkey.
But all these guys are going to get their shot.
Well, there's no doubt Kevin Durant, if he stays healthy, what a career he's got ahead of him.
I thought you were going to ask me if he was going to make the team in 12.
Six to shoot for Westbrook. He'll launch a three, and he'll hit a three. How about doubling your three-point output in the gold medal game for Russell Westbrook?
Now, we talked about this crowd and what we've seen in this week here in Istanbul. Team USA has really quieted this raucous crowd.
Gunloom falls off the rim. Turkoglu back in the game and knocks down a triple. Cuts it to 17 with 3 minutes to go for gold. Mike Krzyzewski twice lost in the semis in the World Championships. Has a chance for World Championship gold as Westbrook is fouled by Onan.
Right now, Team USA's enemy is not Turkey, but the clock. If they manage this clock, they'll be wearing gold medals.
Onan gets a big hand as he comes out with four fouls. Goulart back into the lineup. Kevin Durant looking for another three. 2.5 minutes to go in Istanbul.
I'd let Osik play one-on-one and just foul him.
How about Iguodala just trying to take it away?
Yeah, exactly. Let him go one-on-one. If you have to foul him, you foul him.
Among all the players we've talked about, we've given Lamar Odom a lot of credit off the bench with Westbrook and Gordon, but Andre Iguodala has done some job defensively against players who are normally 4 or 5 inches bigger than him.
Yeah, he's got a tough act to follow now because Doug Collins, his new coach of the 76ers, is going to make him a defensive stopper. This is a guy that's averaged 16 points, 6 rebounds, 5 assists in his 6 years.
Like Iguodala got a hand in on that one. And that'll be his third personal foul. They're showing the fans on the scoreboard, and now Hedo Turkoglu, rest of the Turkish players giving a hand. They know the game has gotten away. This has been one of the biggest events in Turkish sports history. They finished third at the FIFA World Cup in soccer. Everyone we talked to, Fran, they expected the U.S. to win. They were happy to get here. They thought their team might have a chance, but they are so proud of these players.
First medal. These guys are still going to be national heroes.
Derrick Rose doubled. They really appreciate the effort given. Iguodala coming flying in on the feed from Westbrook.
Now, Team USA, give them credit, man. They came in here, and defensively, they shut Turkey down. They played with a lot of poise.
Take a listen to the chant. This is Istanbul, no way out. They chant it all the time at basketball.
Well, that USA charter will be leaving about 4 a.m. to get back to the States, as many of these guys have training camps starting in 2 weeks. Give these guys credit for spending their summer representing the three letters on the jersey.
Knocked out of bounds. Yesterday in the semifinal round, played on the 11th of September, and that certainly did not lose anything here in Istanbul for these U.S. players. Lamar Odom, Kevin Durant, among many, talking about the pride they wear in the USA uniform and remembering those lost 9 years ago. Noticeably absent from the rotation today, Kevin Love, who's going to come in. A lot of hugs on the bench. A lot of people didn't think they could do it.
Well, they checked their egos at the door of the training camp in Las Vegas. A lot of these guys are young stars. And Coach K's greatest strength, I've always said, is the way he manages people.
And Fran, this has really set up USA basketball, because the Redeem team won gold. This was a year where, because of free agency, because of injuries, they all didn't come back. And now you're looking at 12 with a full roster. And one would hope in 2014 bringing that A unit to Spain for the World Championships. The darkest days 8 years ago in Indianapolis appear to be wiped away. Danny Granger getting some action. And Turkey throws it away down court. 42 seconds to go in Istanbul. Kevin Durant gets a hug as he heads out. 28 points, a hug for Coach Krzyzewski. He said it a month ago. Don't be selfish, be the scorer. And he has been that and more for Team USA. Hugs all around on the United States bench. Turkish team gave it a good run. Kevin Durant and company just a little bit better. The realization setting in, all the hard work. And the gold medals to be handed out after the game. It's been 16 years since the U.S. won gold. Russell Westbrook will hold the ball. The seconds tick off, and after 16 long years, the United States, the world champions of basketball. The Americans in the crowd in Istanbul, enjoying a moment, erasing the bad memories, and great sportsmanship here in Istanbul. The crowd, which gave its Turkish heroes its hand, and now all the Turkish players shaking hands with the gold medal winners.
They've not only won over the last 3 years, but they've won with class and dignity. It started with the team in 06 that lost to Greece in the semifinals. They picked it up in 07 when they won the FIBA Americas Championship. 08, it wasn't easy at the end. They beat Spain. And then maybe Coach K's best coaching job of all, taking 12 new players, 6 under the age of 22, building a cohesive team, going on the road essentially, and getting the job done. And they did it emphatically tonight.
Kevin Durant carried the team in this tournament. 28 points tonight, 7 three-pointers, and in the last three games, Fran, the quarters, the semis, and in the gold medal game, Kevin Durant carried this offense home.
He's not the best player in the world at the incredible age of 21. He's awfully darn close. It's scary to think what he's going to be like 4 or 5 years down the road.
Well, I know back in Oklahoma, they can't wait to get him back in the state, and the Oklahoma City Thunder have a great year looking ahead. But he was the offense for the U.S., which put a program together 4 years ago. Mike Krzyzewski taking over as head coach. Had a great select team. Coach K now 49-1 as the national head coach and adds a gold to the bronze he picked up in Japan and the gold Olympic medal 2 years ago in Beijing.
It's been a great run because they've done it, as I said, they do it. They may not have the fanciest offense, and a lot of these European coaches are saying, what is your team doing? But they play well together. They utilize their talents offensively. But to get this team to buy in defensively the way they have the entire tournament has been a masterful coaching job.
We'll be back in just a bit with the medal ceremonies. We're going to head to the studio after the break. Team USA, the gold medal champs. Back in Istanbul, where Kevin Durant has been named the most valuable player of the 2010 FIBA World Championships, the USA knocking off Turkey in the gold medal game. Welcome inside the Olympic Dome. And along with Fran Fraschilla, I'm Mark Kestisher. Great atmosphere right now. All the nations of the final three teams getting their medals. We'll get to that in a moment. Let's talk about Team USA not only getting a gold medal this evening here in Istanbul, but this clears their schedule toward the 2012 Olympics
they
in London.
They qualified for the Olympics in London, and teams like Argentina and Brazil are happy too, because that means two teams come out of FIBA Americas besides Team USA. But most importantly, it's how they won with grace, class, intensity, teamwork. Kevin Durant, they rode his back, and he was as good as a player could be in this kind of environment. He played through contact, he made shots, he played good defense, Mark. He was a good passer. He had a fabulous tournament that he can take back to Oklahoma City now as he gets ready for his fourth NBA season and a gold medalist in the World Championships.
Broke all kinds of records, had the highest scoring single game for a U.S. World Championship team. Turkey getting their silver medals. Great finish for Turkey in their home country. Huge victory last night over Serbia. A sold-out crowd. You can't ask for better atmosphere than a host team that took it all the way to the gold medal game. And they were up to the task, tried to play it nose-to-nose early, physical-to-physical, but just not enough to get past this U.S. team.
Well, remember 2 weeks ago we talked about Greece, Argentina, Spain, and Team USA as the four co-favorites. Three of those teams went by the wayside. Turkey stayed undefeated until the gold medal game. They just didn't have enough. Team USA's defense never let them get it going. But you can tell right now, let's put it this way. The nickname for the national team is the 12 Giant Men. And they've got 12 giants standing up on that podium right now that are going to get a silver medal in the World Championships.
Lithuania already picked up their bronze. Turkey's got the silver. Team USA coming up next to get the gold medals. First time since 1994. Bojan Tanjevic looking on. Turkey, little extra time to get the love from the crowd as the U.S. awaits their turn. Look at Steph Curry and the rest of the U.S. team, arm in arm. And here they come up to the podium.
Well, they gave up their summers to play for Coach K and represent the United States. Not one of these players had Olympic experience in 08. The veterans were solid, Chauncey Billups, Lamar Odom. And they asked Kevin Durant 6 weeks ago to carry this team offensively. He was reluctant at first because he didn't want to be the focus of attention, but it was impossible for him not to be.
Chauncey Billups putting that gold medal on, the finals MVP from 2004 with the Pistons, can now add gold to his collection. The MVP is coming up next. Kevin Durant, a gold medal winner. He has been a winner at every stage of basketball in his life. Sure, he would have liked that most valuable player losing out to LeBron, but he'll take the gold, and so will Derrick Rose. Russell Westbrook taking a look at his gold medal. A couple of guys who played well, weren't really in the rotation at the end, but certainly did their part this summer, in Danny Granger, Steph Curry, and what a summer it's been for Eric Gordon that he's going to bring back to Los Angeles with the Clippers.
He played with great confidence. He shot 50% from behind the arc for most of this tournament. And all these guys, remember, six of them under the age of 22, very little playoff experience. How does this help them when they go back to teams that are on the rise? What does it do for their confidence?
Tyson Chandler picking up his gold. He was on the qualifying team of 2007. That got Team USA to Beijing. And the man who has run the show, Mike Krzyzewski. Now he gets to think about Princeton, his first game, November 14th. But first, he'll put that gold around his neck. Olympic gold and world championship gold for Coach K. Team USA getting its picture with the gold medals here in Istanbul. Nearly midnight in Turkey. I don't think anybody's going to be sleeping anytime soon.
And Team USA will celebrate and then head for the airport about 3 a.m. All these guys, I'm sure, anxious to get home, get some rest before training camp opens. For Kevin Durant, it's September 27th.
Bob Elphinstone from FIBA handing the Naismith Trophy. The Naismith is coming back to the U.S. for the first time in 16 years. Coming back to the birthplace of basketball. The red and silver confetti falling from the skies here inside the Olympic Dome. Lamar Odom's used to this, isn't he? Couple of celebrations in Los Angeles.
Well, how about the leadership of Lamar Odom and Chauncey Billups throughout this tournament? What hasn't been just on the court, but off as well. And Lamar Odom was brilliant the last three games.
The U.S. contingent capturing the moment. And now the national anthem.
was his average the last three games? Anybody know?
The national anthem for Team USA, and welcome back inside the Olympic Dome in Istanbul with Brent Fraschilla. I'm Mark Kestisher. First time since 1994, Team USA has won gold in the World Championships. Kevin Durant's last three games, really emblematic of what he's done the last 2 weeks.
Well, he made shot after shot. He amazed everybody in this building. I'm sure people who watch him play for the Oklahoma City Thunder have seen this before, but just absolutely brilliant. And he did it within the flow of the offense, Mark. Didn't force a lot of shots. And you talk about efficient. He certainly was efficient and brilliant.
When you think about the 2010 World Championships, you'll think about Kevin Durant. What'll be the second thought? Will it be the defense of Team USA and how gritty they were?
Two more thoughts. The defense certainly was tremendous, and then the overall atmosphere of being at a world championship and just understanding the passion people have for basketball around the world. And Team USA made everybody back in the United States very proud with the way they played. They did it as a team. They did it. They checked their egos. They were tremendous.
Oh, we were very privileged to be here and watch it. Fran, great doing the tournament with you, and we'll have a safe trip back to the United States as the U.S. will bring gold back home. Team USA winning the gold medal match 81-64. Kevin Durant with 28 points named the MVP. Coming up next, it's boxing. Vladimir Klitschko versus Samuel Peter. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. And for Fran Fraschilla and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Mark Kestisher. Goodbye from Istanbul, where Team USA, for the first time in 16 years, the new world champions.